Texas motorists are safer thanks to roadside barriers that keep vehicles from leaving the roadway. W-beam median guardrail barriers and median concrete barriers both work well by themselves. But when the two systems are joined, it's that transition space that has not been MASH approved until now.
Anytime we transition from one type of barrier to another that has big differences in deflection, it's important to have a gradual transition to keep the public safe. And this project specifically addresses the transition from double-sided guardrail to a rigid concrete rail.
We do have two crash tested, MASH crash tested devices, which is the double-sided double beam guardrail, and then we do have the concrete bear. However, we don't have the connection tested between them, how you transition between one to the other. And that is not a simple task to do. We have to make sure the connection is, transition is really as safe as possible without any safety or performance issue.
The double-sided guardrail is much cheaper to install than the concrete barriers. Districts might not have the funds to install concrete all the way down, but they might have enough funds to install double-sided guardrail. Also, double-sided guardrail allows for drainage underneath, which concrete barriers do not allow for enough drainage. This project allows us to make that choice and to make the best choice for the public. So
then you want to have the stiffness to be kind of matching going from the WBM, medium WBM to the concrete. And that's where you start having a double WBM, meaning is you're going to have four WBM nested on one side, nested on the other side. And then even for the tar, as they come down, they're going to be engaging the face of the concrete. So you want to have a rub rail. So that's another W-beam down there that just kind of make sure the tires don't engage with the post as well. And the post will be increased. So instead of having a post of 6 foot three, they can be down to three, you know, half of that, 3 foot, 1.5 frequency, and you keep going that to even a quarter frequency. So with that, your stiffness, let's say, going to be more like, you know, this much, and you're going to go this much to go to very stiff concrete and ensure you have a really smooth transition.
The full-scale crash test in this instance showed us that this transition was going to be safe for the public and anywhere that it's impacted.
The test is basically you want to target the critical point. And because you have transition, you're going to have critical points. And this will be for the truck as well, for the small car. So there are two cars, two trucks, and three critical points there that we test that. And they're all under MASH. Now, all the tests were done at 100 kilometers an hour, 60 miles per hour, at 25 degree impact angle.
From here, TxDOT will develop a standard, and we will we'll distribute the standard to our districts and make the designers aware of its availability and that it is MASH compliant and it has been tested in accordance with MASH.
For more information and to find the publications for this project, please visit the TxDOT Research Library at the link shown below.